Hi kids, how are you all? I hope you all must be fine, right? So today we are going to read for class 5 Science Olympiad. And in class 5 Science Olympiad, what we are going to do? We are going to discuss the level 2 question, previous year question paper of SOF NSO. Okay, so in our previous session, we have already discussed some questions, and in our today's session, we are going to discuss some more previous year questions of level 2 exam. Okay, so are you all ready for it? Yes, so let's get started. Our first question, select the animal group that possesses similar body covering. A, option A, crocodile, ostrich, newt. B, elephant, frog, rhinoceros. C, turtle, tortoise, snail. D, porcupine, hedgehog, crocodile. So in the question, it is asked, select the animal group that possesses similar body covering. Okay, so among whatever options are given here, the correct answer is option C, because turtle, tortoise and snail, they possess similar body covering. They have a hard covering on their body. Okay, so coming to the next question, the given figure shows plant parts labeled as P, Q, R and S. Which of the following options correctly lists the plants in which labeled part is edible? Okay, so options are A, P, broccoli, cauliflower, lettuce. B, Q, tapioca, turnip, onion. C, R, coriander, spinach, fenugreek. D, S, potato, ginger, sweet potato. So here the plant is labeled as P, Q, R and S. Okay, and we have to find out which correctly lists the plants in which labeled part is edible. Okay, so what is the correct answer here? Here correct answer is option C, R. What is R here? R refers to the leaf. Yes, as per this given diagram. So coriander, spinach, fenugreek. So these are also means they also represent the leaves of the corresponding plants. That's why the correct answer is option C. Coming to the next question, read the given statement regarding the liver and select the correct one. Beat 1, in beam balance, fulcrum is in the middle. Beat 2, a nutcracker is an example of third class liver. Beat 3, in tongs, the fulcrum and the load are at the two ends. Beat 4, seesaw is an example of first class liver. And the options are A, 1, 3 and 4 only, B, 2 only, C, 3 and 4 only, D, 1 and 2 only. So we have to find out the correct statement regarding the liver. Okay, so whatever options are given here, okay, so here in beam balance, fulcrum is in the middle, this one is correct. A nutcracker is an example of third class liver, no, it is wrong, it is an example of second class liver. In tongs, fulcrum and loads are at the two ends, this one is correct. Seesaw is an example of first class liver, yes, this is also correct. So here correct answer is option A, 1, 3 and 4 only, got it? Coming to the next question, unscramble the letters given in column 2 to make meaningful terms and match column 1 with column 2 to select the correct option. Column 1, tropical storm with spinning winds. Q, hollow top of the volcano. R, extended period of dry weather. S, magma erupting from a volcano. And the options are given as A, B, C, D. So we have to unscramble. This unscramble letters are there, and you have to here R A C E R T. Okay, so it will be greater than U G H O R D T, it will be drought, then E L O C Y N C, this one is cyclone, A-L-A-B, this one is lava. Okay, so when we try to match the column, then tropical storm with spinning wind, that is our cyclone, so we can write here beat 3. Okay, then Q, hollow top of the volcano, that is the crater, beat 1. Extended period of dry weather, that is drought, beat 2. And magma erupting from a volcano, that is larva. So it is P3, Q1, R2, S4. Where it is present? It is present in option D. So option D is the correct answer. Okay, coming to the next question. The given diagram shows three gears arranged to work in a mechanical system. If gear R moves in an anti-clockwise direction, in which direction would gear P and Q move? So options are A, P anti-clockwise, Q clockwise, B, P clockwise, Q clockwise, C, P clockwise, Q anti-clockwise, D, P anti-clockwise, Q anti-clockwise. So that the given diagram shows three gears arranged to a valve in a mechanical system. Okay, gear R moves in an anti-clockwise direction. So in which direction would gear P and Q move? That we need to find out. Okay, so it is given gear R moves in an anti-clockwise direction. So if it is moving like this, it is in contact with Q, so Q will move like this. Okay, and if it is moving like this, so this P also will move like this. Can you imagine? Okay, when it is moving, it will also move in this type of direction. So this one is clockwise direction, and here this one is also clockwise direction. So the correct answer is option B, that is P clockwise, Q is also clockwise. Coming to the next question, study the given relationship. Soluble impurities, insoluble impurities, X, Y. Select the option that correctly identifies the separating methods X and Y. Options are A, evaporation distillation, B, distillation filtration, C, sedimentation decantation, D, filtration distillation. So, soluble impurities X, insoluble impurities Y. So, for separating this soluble impurities, the method what we use, that is the distillation. Okay, and here the insoluble impurities that we use, that for removing those, we use filtration method. So here the correct answer is option B, distillation for removing soluble, separating soluble impurities, filtration for separating insoluble impurities. Okay, coming to the next question, study the table given below describing the characteristics of four animals W, X, Y and Z. Description: it has six legs, it breathes through gill, it possesses hollow bones, and W, X, Y, Z, it is showing the properties. What properties which one is having? Which of the following is likely to be a mosquito? A, W, B, X, C, Y, D, Z. So here, it has, if you talk about mosquito, it has six legs, right? It breathes through gills. No, it does not breathe through gills. It breathes through the skin. And in the skin, there are some holes known as spiracle. Okay. Then it possesses hollow bones. No, it does not possess hollow bones. So, as per this, Y is the correct answer. And where Y is present? It is present in option C. Got it? Coming to the next question, X changes to Y on condensation. Select the option that correctly represents the arrangement of molecule in X and Y. And in A, B, C, D, different options are given. So, X changes to Y on condensation. You know what is condensation? In condensation, gas molecules, gas from the gaseous state, a matter is converted to the liquid state. Okay, and you know about the arrangement of molecules in gaseous state, the particles are far apart from each other, and in liquid state particles are comparatively closer to each other than the gaseous state. Okay, so here B is the correct answer. Why? Because the particles are far apart from each other, so this can be the gas, and here the particles are little close to each other, so it can be the liquid. So gas to liquid, that is the condensation. Got it everyone? Coming to the next question, Five objects A, B, C, D, and E of the same volume but different masses are put into a tank of water as shown here. Which of the following is most likely to be the mass of object D? Option A 45 gram, B 58 gram, C 74 gram, D 90 gram. So in the question it is given five objects A, B, C, D and E of the same volume but different masses are put into tank of water. Okay, we have to find out which of the following is most likely to be the mass of the object D, this one. So mass of A we know that is 52 gram, B 41 gram, C 62 gram and E 85 gram. That means in this medium, whatever medium is there here, in that liquid medium, in liquid medium A, B these are and C these are floating, okay. D is present in between and E is at the bottom, okay. So that means these 52, 41, 62, they are comparatively lighter, that's why they are floating on the, they are floating, okay. 85, it is having more weight, that's why it has been sunk to the bottom and D is in between them. So the value of D, it should be between 62 to 85. Why 62? Because 52, 41, these are less than 62 and as D is present in between, so its value should be between, should be more than these three values but less than 85. What it? So 52, 41, 62, more than that and less than 85. What type number is there among the options? So among the options, 74 is between these numbers. Okay. So here the correct answer is option C. Coming to the next question, select the animal that has similar body covering as the animal shown here. So here there is a polar bear, okay, and four other options are there. We have to select the animal that has similar body covering as the given animal, okay. So here the correct answer is option D. Coming to the next question, in India, crops that are grown in winter are called rabi crops. Which of the following are rabi crops? B1 radish, B2 mustard, 3 rice, 4 millet, 5 cabbage, 6 watermelon, 7 peach, 8 cauliflower. Options are A 1, 2 and 7 only, B 3, 4, 5 and 6 only, C 4, 6 and 8 only, D 1, 2, 5 and 8 only. Okay. So in India, crops that are grown in winter are known as rabi crops and we have to find out which of the following are the rabi crops. Okay. So here what will be the answer? Radish, yes. Then mustard, yes. Rice, no. Millet, no. Cabbage, yes. Watermelon, no. Peach, no. Cauliflower, yes. So the options are 1, 2, 5 and 8. Which is there? It is present in option D. Got it? Coming to the next question, select the option that correctly represents chemical change X and physical change Y. So options are A, bending of pear, ripening of mango, B, cooking of food, melting of ice, C, rusting of iron, burning of crackers, D, formation of cloud, germination of a seed. So we are, as per the given options, the correct answer is option B. Why? Because cooking of food, that is the, that represents the chemical change, and melting of ice, it represents the physical change. So you know in chemical change new substances are formed and we cannot get back the original substance. So when we cook food, we cannot get back that raw food. Yes. And melting of ice, it is a physical change. What happens in case of physical change? Only the physical state of the substance changes. It may be from solid to liquid, liquid to gas, gas to liquid, liquid to solid, anything it may be. Okay. So here the correct answer is option B. Coming to the next question, characteristic and materials. Definite volume, opaque, definite shape. and what material it's possessing, which property it is given to us. Select the option that correctly identifies X, Y and Z. Okay, so here the correct answer is option C. How it is the correct option? Let us check. X, water. Yes, water has definite volume. Okay, water, it has definite volume. It is not opaque, it is transparent, light can pass through it. Okay, and definite shape? No, it does not have any definite shape. As it is a liquid, where it is kept, it takes the shape of the container. Okay, next one is Y. It is the wooden seat. So wooden seat, that is a solid, it has a definite volume and it is opaque, light cannot pass through it. In also it has definite shape. Then coming to the Z, that is glass. Yes, glass is a solid, it has definite volume, but it is not opaque because light can pass through the glass. And yes, as it is a solid, it has definite shape. So the correct answer is option C. Coming to the next question, which of the following is not a greenhouse gas? Option A, carbon dioxide. B, methane. C, ozone. D, sulfur dioxide. Okay, so here carbon dioxide, we have to find which is not a greenhouse gas. Carbon dioxide, greenhouse gas, methane is also, ozone is also, but sulfur dioxide is not. So correct answer is option D. Coming to the next question, which of the following groups of seeds contains only dicot seeds? Option A, wheat, rice, maize. B, pea, maize, bean. C, pea, bean, gram. D, maize, gram, pea. So here the correct answer is option C, that is pea, bean and gram. These seeds, they contain only dicot seeds. Okay, coming to the next question, which of the following belong to the same group to which microbes that cause plague X and polio Y belong? Okay, option A, QR, B, PR, C, Q, P, D, P, S. So we have to find out to which of the following belong to the same group to which microbes that causes plague and polio belong. So plague, it occurs due to Yersinia, which is a bacteria. Okay, and this one is it, X. And polio, that occurs for polio virus, and it is also a virus. So this one is Y. So Q is X is Q, Y is P. Where it is present? It is present in option C. Okay, so you can see it, P, that is coronavirus, everyone knows, right? Yes. Coming to the next question, observe the given figure. So from which of the following layers does molten magma come out when a volcano erupts? Option A, P, B, Q, C, R, D, both Q and S. So we have to find out from which of the following layer does molten magma come out when a volcano erupts. So here the correct answer is this one, R. Okay, so from this portion the molten magma comes out. So correct answer is option C, that is R. Coming to the next question, Renu classified plants into groups as shown in the table shown here. Which of the following is the most appropriate heading for the group X and Y? In X, fern, musk, pine. In Y, dahlia, potato, onion. Options are A, aquatic plant, terrestrial plant. B, heterotrophs. Y, autotrophs. Then C, non-flowering plants, flowering plants. D, parasitic plants, insectivorous plants. Okay, so these fern, musk, pine, these are non-flowering plants, and dahlia, potato, onion, these are flowering plants. So here the correct answer is option C. Coming to the next question, Rini was asked to write some involuntary actions. She has written some voluntary actions also as shown in the list. Which one? Chewing food. 2. Sitting upright on a table. 3. Digestion of food. 4. Beating of heart. 5. singing a song, 6 dancing, 7 breathing, 8 writing a letter. Select the option that contains only involuntary actions. Option A, 1, 3, 7 and 8 only. B, 2, 6 and 7 only. C, 3, 4 and 7 only. D, 2, 5, 6 and 7 only. Okay. So, Rini was asked to write some involuntary action. But she has written some voluntary action also. So, we have to select which are involuntary action. Do you know what is voluntary action and what is involuntary action? Involuntary action, voluntary action that is under our will. Those actions are performed as per our will. Okay. Involuntary actions, we do not have any control on them. They occur automatically. So we have to tick the involuntary action. So chewing food, it is voluntary action. Sitting upright on a table, voluntary action. Digestion of food, we cannot control it. It is involuntary action. Beating of heart, it is also involuntary. Okay. Then singing a song, voluntary. Dancing, voluntary. Breathing, involuntary. Writing a letter, voluntary. So our answer is 3, 4, 7. So 3, 4, 7 is present in option C. So option C is the correct answer. Okay. Coming to the next question, Ruchi categorized animals on the basis of their body coverings. She made three groups and by mistake placed one wrong member in each group. Identify the wrong member of each group and select the correct option. Group 1, so snake, lizard, crab. Group 2, sloth, platypus, salmon. Group 3, penguin, pigeon, grasshopper. Okay. So, options are A, crab of group 1 should be interchanged with grasshopper of group 3. B, salmon of group 2 should be replaced with toad. C, platypus of group 2 should be interchanged with pigeon of group 3. D, grasshopper of group 3 should be replaced with parakeet. So, here she had made three groups and by mistake placed one wrong member in each group. So, as per the options given, option D is the correct answer. That grasshopper, it should be replaced with parakeet. Why so? Because penguin, pigeon, lizard, bird, parakeet is also a bird. So, but grasshopper, that is an insect. That's why option D is the correct answer. Okay. So, this much for today's session. Let's meet you in the next session. And in the next session, we are going to discuss some more previous year 11-2 questions of SOF and SO. Okay. And till then, read mindfully. Meet you soon. Bye-bye, everyone.